Hi, my name is Dr. Gary Adams. I'm a dentist at Natural Dentist Associates in Rockville, Maryland. And today we are going to talk about dental implants versus root canals and crowns. This is a very common thing that people will sometimes become faced with. Sometimes they will have been told they need a root canal by another dentist, and they will question whether or not they should have that root canal done. They may have had a root canal in the past, and that root canal now is not good anymore. And then they're asking us for a second opinion on whether or not they should in fact do a root canal retreatment and save their tooth, or should they remove and replace a tooth with a dental implant. Long story short, I cannot always make that decision for you. What I will do is I will make a recommendation. If your tooth cannot be fixed, and my opinion is it can't be repaired, I will recommend you remove and replace a tooth with a dental implant. There's no question that teeth can be saved in certain circumstances with root canals and crowns. And there is some level of predictability that can be done with. One of the problems with a root canal procedure is root canals are not always 100% successful. And success is measured both initially and over the long term. A lot of dentists will measure root canal success, that is, initially. So what they will do is they will say, in my office, I will do a root canal, and the success rates will be between 85% to 90%. That's pretty typical for root canal therapy that's done properly. But the question is, will that tooth still be in your mouth in 10 years? And that's definitely a good question. Because I will be the first to tell you that I placed over 1,000 dental implants successfully, and a majority of the teeth that I have removed and replaced with dental implants are root canal failures. So there is no question that root canal therapy does not always work out as planned. What I will do in my office is I will take a look at your tooth. I will look to see if it's a structurally sound tooth. I will look to see if I believe it's a good root canal candidate. And I will let you know what I believe the likely prognosis is for your tooth. And I will tell you how long I believe it'll last. And I will then let you know that you can always have the tooth removed and replaced with a dental implant if you like. I'll let you know what the fee is to do the root canal and the crown. I will also let you know what the fee is to do a dental implant. I will also let you know that once a dental implant is placed and it's successful, and the reported success rate for a dental implant is 95% by way of the dental implant literature. I will also let you know that once a dental implant is successful, that is initially successful, that very few dental implants after a 5-year period will actually fail. So it is my opinion that a dental implant is a much more, is practically speaking, a much better financial decision. Okay, that is my opinion, but I have the right to have my opinion, and that is what I think. However, I will also tell you that I have done root canals. I've had done many root canals that have been successful, and I've seen teeth that have had, good root canal candidate teeth that have had root canals and crowns done, and some of them were done, long before I was a dentist. So they do work out. I will tell people that from what I've seen in my office, that most people, if a root canal and a crown is done on a tooth that is a good root canal candidate tooth, that most of the time that therapy will last 10 years if the root canal is done properly. I will discuss some of the reasons why root canal teeth don't last forever. First and foremost, when a tooth needs a root canal, it is devitalized. What a dentist will do is they will, there's some reason why the dental, the pulp, which is a nerve, artery, and vein inside the tooth, is dead or dying. The dentist will go into the canals that are, in the central part of the roots of the teeth. They will clean these roots. They will attempt to sterilize them and fill them with a material. And then we will put a crown on top. All the treatment is targeted at sterilizing the inner part of the tooth and sealing it up so bacteria does not get back into that tooth. The tooth is a very porous, it is somewhat porous material. I question whether or not teeth can really truly be sterilized. Most likely what we are really doing when we're doing a root canal is we are encapsulating bacteria into the tooth. When a root canal is done very well, it is sealed up quite well. And the hope is that bacteria, doesn't get into the tooth. And if it is still in your tooth, it doesn't leak that back out and infect the underlying gum and bone that surrounds your teeth. Also, there's no question that the way in which a tooth after a root canal versus before the root canal sits in your jawbone. First and foremost, the nerve in the artery and the vein that once went into the tooth has now been severed, and you essentially have a dead tooth in your head. That tooth is no longer receiving nutrients from your body. The tendency is for that tooth to get brittle over time, and it will become more prone to fracture. Certainly that is one of the reasons why root canal teeth, from what I've seen, don't oftentimes last more than 10 years. Hopefully this provides you with some insight. Again, my name is Dr. Gary Adams. I'm a dentist at Natural Dentist Associates in Rockville, Maryland. If you find yourself in a position where you need to decide between a root canal and a dental implant, I would be happy to provide you with my opinion. I perform both of these services, so I am not partial to either one. I will let you know which one I would do if I were you. I'll give you my honest opinion about where I think your money's best spent. But like I said, at the end, it will be your decision as to which one you do, unless I feel like your tooth cannot be fixed. If I feel like your tooth cannot be fixed, I will not make an attempt to fix your tooth. So again, my name is Gary Adams. I'm a dentist at Natural Dentist Associates in Rockville, Maryland. Our telephone number is 301-770-2270. Give us a call. I will provide a complimentary consultation for anything that you would like to talk about.